word, right? But Isa alayhi salam was given the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to breathe into it, and it actually became a bird. Imam Tabari, famous historian and commentator of the Quran from the 3rd century Hijri, he recounts this incident, and he says that Isa alayhi salam was sitting in the company of disciples who would write the Holy Scripture. So as he received revelations, he had disciples who were scribes who would write the Holy Scripture. So he took a handful of clay and said to his disciples, "Shall I make for you a live bird from clay?" So they replied, "Are you capable of doing this?" And he said, "Yes, by the will of my Lord. Yes, by the will of my Lord." So he took the clay and shaped it to resemble a bird. So he made it look like a bird. And then he blew upon it saying, "Be a living bird by the will of Allah." And it became a live bird and flew away in the sky, spreading its wings. And once it disappeared from the public eye, it turned back into clay. So this was one of the miracles. He goes on, وَأُبْرِئُ الْأَكْمَهَ وَالْأَبْرَصَ وَأُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. I heal him who was born blind and the leper, and I raise the dead again by Allah's leave. Notice that for every single miracle, what does he say? بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ, by Allah's leave. Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, mentions that, as Shaykh Yusuf mentioned, that Isa alayhi salam was sent in an age when the science of medicine was at its peak. So the miracles that were given to the prophets had to do with whatever was in those days. So in the case of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it was poetry. And thus the Quran was sent as a miracle. And at the time of Musa alayhi salam, it was magic. And thus his miracles had to do with breaking magic. So in this case, Isa alayhi salam was sent in the age of science and medicine being at its peak at that time. So he was given such cures and remedies which the experts of the field could not compete with. And people understood that these were divine miracles, as scientists could never bring the dead back to life or cure those who were born blind. Right? Even today, if someone has passed away, you know, they have passed on. Right? You can't bring them back to life once the ruh has their soul has left their body. Imam Qurtubi mentions that there were four people that Isa alayhi salam brought back to life. Al-Athir, and he was a friend of Isa alayhi salam. Ibn al-Ajuz, Bintul Ashir, and Sam ibn Nuh. So Al-Athir was a friend of Isa alayhi salam, and he had died just a few days earlier. So Isa alayhi salam prayed on his behalf, and he came back to life, and he lived for a long period, and he also had a son after that. So he actually died, he passed away. Isa alayhi salam made dua to Allah to bring him back to life. He came back, he actually lived for a long period of time and had a son as well. Ibn al-Ajuz, he was carried upon his deathbed after having passed away. Isa alayhi salam prayed for him, and thus he came back to life. And Isa alayhi salam then carried his deathbed back to his family, so meaning the person who had passed away, he brought it back to his family, and they were simply amazed by that, because, you know, this person was dead, now he's not there anymore, and he's back alive. Bintul Ashir was a woman, and her family was crying over her dead body. So commonly, you know, family members get sad, it's a difficult time, so they were crying over her dead body when Isa alayhi salam was informed, and he was requested to come and pray for her, so as to obviously relieve the family of their agony and their pain. So Isa alayhi salam came and he prayed for her, and after his prayer was accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, she stood up and she proved to her family that she was alive again, making them joyful and making them happy. After these three instances, the disbelievers said to Isa alayhi salam that you can only bring back to life those who have just recently passed away. And it's possible that they weren't really dead. Maybe they were just, you know, temporarily unconscious. They had just been knocked out, perhaps. So therefore, how about this? Why don't you bring back to life Sam ibn Nuh, the son of Nuh alayhi salam, who passed away 4,000 years ago? Yeah, how about that? So Isa alayhi salam replied, he's like, okay, show me his grave. Show me his grave. So they took Isa alayhi salam to his grave, and Isa alayhi salam prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the son of Nuh alayhi salam, Sam, came out of his grave, and he spoke to Isa alayhi salam. So this has all been narrated by Imam Qurtubi. The next miracle, وَأُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا تَأْكُلُونَ وَمَا تَدَّخِرُونَ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ. And I announce unto you what you eat and what you store up in your houses. So Imam Qurtubi goes on and he explains this, and he says the people demanded to see yet another miracle. So these weren't enough. So the bird, right, made out of clay that was brought to life, that wasn't good enough. The dead coming back to life wasn't good enough. So they demanded to see another miracle. So we want to see something else. So they demanded, inform us of what we have eaten and that which we have stored in our homes for tomorrow. Right? So tell us what we ate, you know, what we ate for lunch, what we ate for dinner. Tell us what we ate and tell us what we have in our homes. So Isa alayhi salam, again, as a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pointed towards each one of them. Pointed towards each one of them individually and notified each person of what he had eaten and that which he had stored. Others say that this might have something to do with the food of the buffet, which is coming up next, which I'll explain. So Isa alayhi salam had disciples who were followers, and they're referred to in the Quran as Hawariyun. Hawariyun can be translated as companions, as helpers. And Imam Qurtubi states that there were 12 of the Hawariyun. And this is the Christian view as well. Except in Islam, they are held to be respectable and honest, but they are not the disciples of Jesus. The disciples of Isa alayhi salam are not considered to be prophets. Right? They were ordinary human beings, and they were not free from human errors. So the people said, هَلْ يَسْتَطِيعُ رَبُّكَ أَن يُنَزِّلَ عَلَيْنَا مَائِدَةً مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ. He said, O Isa, son of Maryam, is your Lord able to send down for us a table spread of food from heaven? Is this Lord, this Allah that you talk about, is he able to do that for us? You know, how about a table spread, you know, nice dasturkhan, you know, nice table spread with food from heaven? So Isa alayhi salam said, قَالَ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. Observe your duty to Allah if you are true believers. Right? So you've seen all of these miracles, and now you want a table spread of food from heaven? So they said, no, you know, we want to eat, and we want to satisfy our hearts. And we want to know that truly that you have spoken the truth to us, and we want to witness that. So Isa alayhi salam made dua for it. Isa alayhi salam said, okay, fine, I'll make dua for it. قال الله إني منزلها عليكم فمن يكفر بعد منكم فإني أعذبه عذابا لا أعذبه أحدا من العالمين. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I sent it down for you, I'll send it down, and whosoever disbelieves from amongst you afterwards, so after this one, if you disbelieve, then surely I will punish with a punishment such that I have not punished any of my creatures. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even says, fine, but you better not disbelieve after this one. Because if you do, the punishment is going to be very, very severe. So as it is narrated or reported in in some of the tafsir, some of the commentaries of the Quran, the table landed in front of Isa alayhi salam. So poof, this table lands. And Isa alayhi salam sees the table and immediately he goes into prostration. He goes into sujood to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the disciples, the Hawariyun, do that as well. And while they are in prostration, while they are making sujood, a wonderful aroma assailed their nostrils. I hope everyone had lunch, by the way. From the food, such a smell, such an aroma that they had never experienced before. So Isa alayhi salam, being a man of God, being a prophet of Allah, he doesn't just jump at the table, time for food, let's have a party. No. What does he do? He makes wudu, he offers salah, he prays, and he offers supplication, and then they sat by the table and they started removing the covers. And they were surprised to find a huge fried fish. A huge fried fish without bones placed in the center of the table. And different types of vegetables were set around it. Salt and vinegar flanked by the head of the fish. Flanked its head, and five different kinds of bread were placed at its tail. I'm getting excited because I love bread. There were pomegranates, dates, olives, cheese, eggs. So this was a wonderful buffet of food which was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shama'un, the leader of the disciples, he asked, "Is this the food of paradise? Or is it the food of this world?" So Isa alayhi salam replied to him and he said, "This is food specially created for you." So this was a custom order. Now you can order cakes, create custom made. So this was a custom order. This food is specially created for you. It is neither from paradise and nor is it the food of this world. And Allah said to it, "Be." And so it was. Now, after learning of all the virtues and the miracles of Isa alayhi salam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with, you know, you wonder what exactly was the message of Isa alayhi salam, right? What exactly was it that he preached? What exactly did he want people to do? And some suggest that he actually wanted to be worshipped by people, na'udhu billah, but he actually didn't say so out of humility. So he didn't. So they say that he wanted to be worshipped, but because of his humility, he didn't say it clearly to people. Right? Because he was a very humble person. So the question is, did he tell people not to worship him, and that he is not the Son of God or God himself? Did he address this in any way? This question comes to mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى بَنَ مَرْيَمَ أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُنِي وَأُمِّيَ إِلَهَيْنِ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. And Allah says, and remember when Allah said, O Isa, son of Maryam, Did you say unto mankind, take me and my mother for two gods besides Allah? اتخذني وأمي إلهين من دون الله. Did you actually say that? Isa عليه السلام. قال سبحانك ما يكون لي أن أقول ما ليس لي بحق. إن كنت قلته فقد علمته تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسك إنك أنت علام الغيوب. So he said, pure are you, Subhanak, pure are you, it does not behoove me to say that what is not right for me, right? It is not possible. I cannot say something like this, which is not right for me. Had I said it, you would have